In this short video, we look at the last part of problem 2, part C, where we took the original circuit from part B and added this additional wire right here. Okay, so what's happened now is previously R1 and R2 were in series, and R3 and R4 were in series. But now the obvious simplification to do first is to recognize that R1 and R3 are in parallel, as are R2 and R4. Okay, and if you have two resistors in parallel, so for R1 and R3, then R total is R1, R3 over R1. Plus R3. Okay, and so you've got 2 and 1, so 2 times 1 in the numerator and 2 plus 1 in the denominator, and that's what's actually indicated over here. And so you end up with 667 ohms for each of those. So now we can redraw the circuit so it looks like this. Grounded. This is 500, this is 667, and this is 667. All right, and we're asked for what the voltage is at the common point CD, okay, which is right there. All right, so what is the obvious next step? The obvious next step then is to combine two of these. Ability to control what the image is doing has gone away here a little bit. So this, I add these in series, and I get 11, 67. Okay, and so the voltage right here will be 667 divided by 667 plus 1167 times the voltage in, which is 16 volts. Pardon me for a second, I have to move things. Okay, so the voltage divider now is the 667, which is the resistance down here at the bottom, and the remaining resistor is this combination of 500 and 667. And that's actually indicated over here. It doesn't want to draw for me here. I have to figure out how to do that again. Let's see here. Right there. Okay. And so the voltage at the common point is 5.8 volts, right? So again, what we're doing is we're taking what looks kind of like a mess and putting it into the standard format of a voltage divider. So what were the steps? We combine R1 and R3 in parallel. We combine R2 and R4 in parallel. Those are identical combinations, so they both ended up being equal to this 667. And then we recognize that we had two resistors in series up here. Once we're done combining the R1 and R3, then we combine them together and we end up with something that looks like this. And then we can apply the usual voltage divider relationship. Now, two things have come up in terms of discussions with students on where they had problems on this. And one of the things that maybe some people didn't recognize is that once we tie these two things together, the voltages have to be the same at the two points. Okay? That the voltage is the same everywhere where conductors are connected. So I'm going to pause for a moment, erase a few things, and highlight a few places where the voltages are the same. Okay. So what do we have now is the voltage here is the same everywhere in that region. That's the voltage at C, the voltage at D. It's the same voltage. Okay, so you have a situation where the the voltage is the same there. It's also the same, it's a different value, but it's a constant value everywhere there. And it's a different value and constant everywhere there. So here it's 16 volts, and over here it was 5.8. Okay, and of course down here, everywhere in this whole region, it's equal to zero. We didn't calculate what it was at B, so I'm not going to bother writing that one down. Okay, so that was one thing, is to always remember which parts of the circuit are being held at the same voltage. Whenever you have conductors, at least those that we can treat as ideal conductors, the voltage must be the same everywhere. All right, so I'm going to erase a few things and come back to you again in a second. Okay, so we're back. And so one of the questions that came, the second question that came up, had to do with where does the current flow? And is there actually current flowing in this wire that connects C and D? And it turns out the answer to that in the configuration that we're showing is yes, because the current flows along here and then divides into these two different paths. And the current flowing through R3 is greater than the current flowing through R1, because remember, I equals V divided by R, Ohm's law. Since the voltage across R1 and the voltage across R2 are identical, the currents must be different. So R3 carries twice the current that R1 does. And then if you look below, again, the voltages across R2 and R4 are the same. And so the current that comes down passes through these in this direction too. But the current in R3 and the current in R2 exceed the currents in R1 and R4, so there has to be current flowing in this direction. So some current passes vertically downward from R1 and R2, some of it passes through R3 and then goes across and back to R2, and some goes from R3 to R4. So you can calculate the currents, and then you can see how this is, how the current has to, in this case, has to actually be flowing from D to C in order to have a continuous current flowing all the way around the circuit, which heads around in this direction. Now, I could have drawn this circuit so that we had the 1K over 1K and 2K over 2K, but that wouldn't have been the same circuit as before. And in those circumstances, if we had 2K over here and 1K over here, then the current would only flow vertically in both cases, and there wouldn't be any current flowing horizontally from C to D. So again, you can see this by solving it in piecewise, and hold on for just 1 second. And we'll see that the current flowing like this flows, some flows actually that way. And maybe it's a little easier to see like that. And some flows straight down there, and some flows straight down there. So there's current flowing in these directions. And you can calculate it using piecewise, spice, or you can calculate it again just by taking the voltages and divide by the resistances. All right, so there were a couple little subtle things in this circuit, but the basic idea was to immediately recognize what you could combine and put it into the standard form of the voltage divider shown over here, then apply the voltage divider relationship right here to get the output voltage. And then you can check your answers to see if they make sense by applying Ohm's law. And that's basically it for this problem and the end of this video.